Welcome to today's lecture. This is the fifth lecture on wool. Today's topic is classification and grading of wool. In the previous lecture, I have discussed about the properties of wool. Today we will see the classification and grading, that is based on certain quality characteristics. Wool has to be classified into different category or grades, which is very important for uniformity in quality and for further use and for marketing and their utility in the actual processing and making different products out of it. So we will discuss different what is grading and different kind of grading system, especially American system and European system, and then the Indian system of grading and some typical examples and what are the limitations and other aspects today. Before we go for actual grading, we need to understand briefly about the shearing and post-shearing operations. So shearing is exactly not in this syllabus, but you should be knowing about the basics of shearing from the LPM or farm practices. So generally shearing has certain thumb rules, like what time it should be done, how many times it should be done in a year, like it should be done pre-monsoon or pre-winter, maybe twice in a year. And it can be done generally by manual shearing or sometime by mechanical shearing. And there is another option like chemical shearing. So after shearing, there is post-shearing operations. This is mentioned in our syllabus. So some of the important steps after the shearing, that is the scutting and grading. So the after shearing, the roughly some of the aspects or bad aspects of the wool should be removed, and then there should be grading. So another option is like sorting. So broadly, wool should be separated into different category, and then there is cleaning and scouring. So cleaning and scouring is very, very important. Here first the wool should be washed in plain water, and then it should be washed with soap solution or different kind of detergent, sometime little bit hot water. After that, there has to be drying, and then that is very important, that is the clean dry wool. After that, there will be packing in the sack, that is called baling or bale, in the bags, different kind of cotton bags, and then it should go for the market or trading. So these are the post-shearing operations. Now let us understand what is grading. Grading means the placing of entire fleeces in certain category according to certain quality criteria. Then within grades, wools are classified on the basis of length. That means based on certain fixed criteria, the wool is categorized, and that is called grading. Sometime within a grade, they are further subclassified based on the length. For yarn to be uniform, the wool from which it is made must be uniform, particularly in length and fineness. So these fibers will be used to make yarn, and which will be used for making the garments or clothes. So to get the proper garments or clothes, the yarn should be uniform. And for the yarn to be uniform, the main source of fiber should be uniform, particularly their length and fineness. So that is why grading is important, to bring similar quality of wool in one category. That's the grading. There is wide variation in the wool produced. Hence, grading of wool is necessary according to fineness and length. So that's how it is very important for better quality products in the market during the processing of wool. So here is a flow chart in the process flow, like it comes from the fiber, comes from the sheep, goat, alpacas, as we have discussed earlier. Then it goes to the proper place, like raw fibers, and then there is sorting, and then they are classified into different category, and then it goes for processing. System of grading. So there are different systems. The oldest is the American or blood system. It is now replaced by British or count system. So in the American system, blood means that is depending on the purity of the germplasm. So the actual pure breed is Merino. So if the pure bred Merino, then it is called pure blood. And then if there is a further reduction in the gene content in the breed, then it is reduced to half blood, quarter blood, like that. Then the second system is the British. This is count system or Bradford spinning count. This is technical method by fiber diameter. So basically it depends on the fiber diameter. These numbers refers to the hanks of yarn. That is each 560 yards long. One hank is 560 yards long, which can be spun from 1 pound of clean wool. So we can take 1 pound of clean wool and see how many hank of yarn can be made out of it. That is, each hank is 560 yards. Thus, a 60S wool, 64S wool would yield 64 hanks. That is 64 into 560 yards. That is 35,840 yards of yarn can be made from 1 pound of that quality of wool. So which is around 20.4 miles long. Criteria for grading. As we have discussed earlier also while discussing about the quality of wool, here the major criteria is clean wool content, or we also say clean fleece yield. That is, after shearing, the wool is to be washed, cleaned and dried. And what is the yield? If that yield is more, means that is going to be a better grade. Then fineness, that is the fiber diameter. Lower the fiber diameter, better is the quality. We have discussed many times about the fiber fineness. And then length of staple or staple length. That is the length of the normal wool from the base to the tip without stretching. So that length has an important consequence about the weaving or processing of wool. And then the strength, that is, what is the stretchability or tenacity or load bearing capacity, that is the strength. These four criteria is taken as important for grading. Here we can see that a rough example about the grading, that is in case of American system or blood system. So fine wool, that is the full blood, we can say the length is 2.5 inches and it is very fine and crimpy. Then half blood, it is 3 inches. 3/8 blood, it is 3.5 inches and medium cream. Then 1/4 blood, it is 4 inches and medium coarse. Then below 1/4 blood, that is 4.5 inch long and coarse cream. Then common, that is further low, less than 1/4, and it is 5 inches, very coarse. And the last one is braid, that is 6 inches and the most coarse. So you can observe here, when the diameter increases, the length also increases. So higher the diameter, higher will be the length of the wool fiber. Here is a scorecard for wool judging or grading that is followed in American system, as I have explained, in the blood content or full blood, like that. So the major criteria I have already told, that is the estimated clean wool content, that is 35 points. So it should have high yield per fleece is desirable. Then length, as I mentioned earlier, the different category has different length, which has got 25 points. Then quality or fineness. So the fiber diameter, this is very, very important. So it should have the fine fiber diameter, then it will get more points. That is, total it is 10 points. If it is more coarse, it will have less points. Then soundness, that is about the strength. So fiber should be strong throughout and free from breaks, that is having 10 points. Then purity, that is, there should not be any mixing of hairy fiber and chem fiber or black fiber and brown fibers. In that case, it will have low score. So purity has got 10 points. And then character and color, so which includes crimpiness and color. So if there is a uniform crimpiness, it will have more points. So for this, there is 10 points, and it should not have any mixing of different colors. So total, there is 100 points. Here once again we will see the American grading system and a correlation with the different grade and the fiber diameter and crimpiness. So in the first one, that is the fine grade, which will have a fiber diameter of 20 micron and the crimp per inch, CPI, crimp per inch is 20, that is the huge amount of crimpiness. Then second is hub blood, 24 micron and 14 crimp. Then 3x8 blood, 27 micron and CPI is 12. So you can see when the diameter is increasing, the crimpiness is decreasing. Then 1/4 blood, 31 micron and CPI is 10. Then lower than 1/4 blood, that is 34 micron and CPI is 8. And then the last grade, common or braid, that is 40 micron and above, and the CPI is 4. Here we will see a comparison between British and American grading system. So here you can see the breed of sheep, that is American or Merino. The spinning count is 64S to 80S, as I have told, 64 hank. So higher the hank, that means the diameter is less, because we are taking 1 pound of wool and see how many hanks of yarn can be made. So if it is more number of S, that means the fiber diameter is less or very fine wool. So in this case, type of breed, fine wool, and British grade is British grade as per the spinning count, this is finer than 80S to 64S. And then American grade is fine. The range of diameter is 17.7 to 22.04. So generally fine wool will be 22, 24 micron and below. And the maximum SD, that is the standard deviation, 3.59 to 5.19. Then there is another example in case of ram bullet. Here the spinning count is 62 to 70. This is a cross breed wool, and of course it is in the fine category, and the British grade is 64 to 62S, and American grade is hub blood, and the range of diameter is 22 to 25 almost, and the standard deviation is 5.89 to 6.49. So this is a comparison between two systems. There are large number of such different category as per the spinning counts and the blood grade, but I am not going into those details. Only two variety I have shown it for understanding. So classification of wool, it is as good as the grading of wool. So wool classifying refer to the grading of the scarted fleece in its whole at the time and place of shearing into parcels for best disposal. That is, when we do the shearing of the wool from the sheep, it has to be broadly categorized and packed, and then it will be sent for disposal and use in the actual wool processing place. So this classing of wool is done on the basis of quality, soundness, length, condition, color and style. So this I have already explained. These are the major criteria for classification or grading of wool. Wool has been classified into based on two categories. One is based on the use and another is based on the breed. So based on use, here we can see two categories of wool, that is apparel wool and carpet wool. Apparel wool means those which are used for making the clothing or garments. They have three subcategories, that is combing wool or staple wool, which are really long. Then the French combing wool or intermediate length. And then the third category is called clothing wool. They are really short wool. So these long wool and short wool undergo two different kind of processing system, which we will discuss later. And in the second category is carpet wool, which are really coarse wool, and they are mainly used for making carpets. In the right side table, you can see, as I have mentioned earlier, based on the spinning count, that is the British system of grading. So here we can see the spinning count, the fiber diameter and the breed. So 64 to 80S, that is very fine merino breed, 60 to 64 fine ram bullet breed, 58 to 60 fine and it is a corno breed, then mid 50s medium Corriedale, about 50 it is medium Suffolk, then 45 to 50 medium Dorset breed, and below 45 S, that is the Corsool, and they are Leicester and Lincoln. So these are all exotic breeds of sheep and their spinning count and fiber diameter. So as I mentioned already, based on length, the apparel wool is categorized into three. There is three main grades based on length from the apparel wool. One is clothing, another is French combing, another is staple. So clothing means that is a sort and used in woolen system of manufacturing, and they will have the lower price. The second one is French combing, that is medium length and combed on the French combs, and they are having higher price. Whereas the third one is the staple wool, that is the longest wool suitable for combing on the noble combs, and they are having the highest price. So this is how in the foreign countries they classify the good quality wool into three categories based on the length. So based on breeds, here are the four different category of classification, that is merinos having diameter 70s or above, that is the more fine, and the use is worsted apparel wool. The second category is crossbred having diameter 54 to 58s, up to 70, that is used for knitting and defense uniforms. The third category is carpet wool, diameter is less than 54s to 45s, they are used for making costly carpets. And then very coarse wool having less than 45s, and they are used for floor carpets and cumbles. So this is a classification based on Western system, based on breed as per the Western way of classifying the breeds or wool. Indian system of grading. Prior to the introduction of grading, the Directorate of Marketing and Inspection, Government of India, prescribed grading for wool to be exported. The grading of fleece is done on visual appraisal of length, fineness, handle or feel, color and vegetable content as bar. Following quality and color grades were mentioned from various categories of wool. So earlier in India, we did not have proper grading rules or specifications. So Directorate of Marketing and Inspection in Government of India made some guidelines for grading of the wool based on certain simple criteria of length and handle, that is by touch, and the vegetable content in the fiber for the purpose of export. So they roughly made into three grades, which I am going to tell in the next. Here is the subjective grades of wool, as I mentioned earlier, that is the three grades. They roughly made a guideline from the Directorate of Marketing, that is grade one, which will be clean, dry in feel, fibers are fairly uniform, average length 7.6 centimeter, and the yield, that is the clean, dry fleece yield, 88.1% and above. The grade two, again, it is clean, dry in feel, average length not less than 5.7 centimeters and yield is 75.1% and above, that is up to 88%. And the grade 3, that is clean, dry in feel, uniform fiber fineness, length not less than 5.7 centimeter and yield is 75% or less. So these are the three grades earlier we had in old system before the actual grading introduced in India. Now we will try to understand the Indian system of grading of wool. Due to heterogeneity of wool obtained from various breeds and variation of wool quality within the breeds, it is necessary that wool be classified and graded for making suitable end uses. Wool grading in India done at shearing stage, as I have mentioned earlier. After cutting, that is after removing the objectionable parts like vegetable matters, etc., wool graded into coarse, medium and fine varieties for each individual breed separately. So as we have discussed earlier, in India we don't have much pure or fine wool breed. Most of the breeds are crossbred type or coarse wool type, so there is lot of variation. So the proper grading is very, very important for proper marketing and use. Indian wool has been arbitrarily grouped into 6 categories based on fineness and the breeds. So number one is fine. The average diameter is 28 micron or less, and the breeds are Hissardale or other crossbred. Then the medium, 28 to 34 micron, the Chokla, Busser, Gaddi. Then coarse medium, 34 to 40 micron, Marwari, Jaisalmeri, Malwa, Pugal. These are the breed. Then coarse, 40 to 50 micron, Malpura, Sonadi, Nali, Patanwadi. Then very coarse, 50 to 80 micron, Mirzapur, Sahabadi and Deccani, and the hairy fiber more than 80 micron. Those are mostly very, very non-descriptive breeds. So here is a special kind of grading recommended by FAO and UNDP grading of wool, that is the Food and Agriculture Organization, and UNDP is United Nations Development Program. So they recommended some kind of grading for better marketing. With a view to orderly market the Rajasthan wool, a grading was introduced under UNDP in 1964. Wools were typed on the basis of fiber fineness, length of staple, color and vegetable matter present in the wool. Washed and unwashed wools were graded separately. Inferior types of wool obtained from belly, legs, strong edge of fleece, black or brown, and stained wools were kept separately. So this is a broad guideline for new grading recommended by UNDP, and they made certain specific criteria for classifying, which I am going to discuss next. So here is the typing of wool as per UNDP, as I mentioned previously. That is, AS is for fine wool, then A for finer wool, B for medium wool, C for strong wool, and D for coarse wool. And then based on the bar content, they had 3 categories, that is light bar 0 to 3%, medium bar 3 to 6%, and heavy bar more than 6%. Bar means the vegetable matters present in the wool. So here there is double letter, that is double A, double B, double C or double D indicate long wool, while single letter indicate the shorter wool. 3 categories of color were mentioned as white, light yellow and heavy yellow, and 3 categories of wool on the basis of bar content, as I already mentioned. So here once again the typing is summarized in this table as per UNDP. So based on fineness or count, that is 56 SS and above, that is they are fine, they are the super A. Then 54 to 56 S, that is the A, 46 to 50 S B, 40 to 44 S C, and below 40 S is D. In case of color, as I mentioned, it is white, light yellow and heavy yellow, and symbolized as LY and HY. Then bar content, as I said, low, medium and heavy, up to 3%, 3 to 6% and more than 6%. And in case of length, if it is more than 6.3 centimeters, then it will be double letters for each category, and if it is 6.3 centimeter and less, then it will be short fiber and it will be indicated by single letters for each category. So we have discussed about one grading recommended by UNDP. Then the second kind of grading system existing in India is the BIS grading of wool as per the Indian standard 2900-1979. BIS grading is based on micron value and it has prescribed 120 grades, but they are not really operative or really easy to put into practice. So briefly I will explain here. For wool quality, they have given the diameter like 34.4 micron and less. That is A. 34.4 to 37 is B. 37.1 to 40 micron is C. And 40.1 micron and above, that is the fiber diameter, that is D. Then in case of length, more than 75 millimeter indicated by double letters and less than 75 millimeter indicated by single letters. In case of bar, low bar less than 3%, medium bar 3 to 5% and heavy bar above 5%. And in case of color, they have given white, then tingy white TW, light yellow LY, heavy yellow HY and other any colors, that is colored. So this is what is recommended by BIS grading. Here is the third kind of grading system, that is the style grading. In order to grade the Rajasthan wool systematically, a revised grading pattern was developed in 1979. So earlier I have discussed about the UNDP recommendation, which was a little bit complicated for actual use in practice. So there is a further revised system, that is style grading. According to this pattern, the fineness classification was based on spinning count as well as micron values. So here they have taken into account both the spinning count and the diameter in microns. This grading system was introduced on the recommendation of FAO experts and is followed by wool producing states like, in addition to Rajasthan, other states like Punjab, Haryana, Jammu and Kashmir, Gujarat and Karnataka. So probably this is more applicable in the real practice. Here is the details about the style grading of wool as recommended by FAO experts. So it has got four type A, B, C, D and the spinning count in case of A 48S and above, B 40 to 48, C 30 to 40 and D less than 30. So it is very simplified and the diameter in micron, that is 33.5 and below, that is the A, 39 to 34. That is B, 43 to 39.5, that is C, and above 43 micron, that is the D. And in case of length, there is a specification like 2 to 4 inches long fibers indicated in double letters. So when it is more than 2 inch, they are in double letters in each category. And when it is up to 2 inch long fibers, they are indicated by single letters like A, B, C, D. So this is about style grading of wool, which is more practicable. Here is the style grade specification for Rajasthan wool. Here we have style grade A, B, C, D, good, good to average, average and inferior, and that has a code number of 1, 2, 3, 4. So in case of A or code 1, wool with good color, washed, scarted and vegetable matter content 0 to 3% with reasonable quality and strength. For second category, wool having yellow color, well scarted with vegetable content 0 to 3% and reasonable in quality and strength. Grade 3, wool of average washing, well scarted and vegetable matter 3 to 6%. And grade 4, wool of poor washed category with vegetable content above 6%. Grading of mohair. So very briefly I want to mention about the grading of mohair. Mohair must meet the same general requirements as wool to be suitable for manufacture of different garments, etc. Mohair is graded by its width in microns, that is the fiber diameter. Fiber diameter, length of fiber, that is minimum 4 inches and fleeces free of kemp are the most desirable characteristics. The fiber diameter of kid mohair is 23 to 29 microns. That of young goats is 30 to 36 microns and the diameter of adult goat is 34 to 40 micron. Actually, as the age increases, the fiber diameter increases. So there are large number of specific grades for mohair. for different category of kids and young and adult, which I don't want to discuss here. It's a very big table. And there is a specific grading system in case of mohair in South Africa, because South Africa is producing very high amount of mohair. Here is a comparison between three different system of grading. One is American system, then British or spinning count, and then grading as per micron, that is the diameter. So we can see here type of wool, the first line, that is the fine wool, American or blood grade, it is fine. English or spinning count grade is finer than 80s, and the micron range is under 17.7 micron, and the limit for standard deviation maximum is 3.59. So this is giving a relationship between three different criteria along with standard deviation. But this is not required for undergraduate student. Maybe for postgraduate student it will be good to understand. Limitations in the existing grading system. So there was an evaluation about the existing grading system by the CSWRI, that is Central Sheep and Wool Research Institute in Obikanagar, Rajasthan. So they evaluated the available prescribed grading system, and the test results of graded lots obtained by the institute are given below. The visual or tactile grading system is highly subjective and does not effectively discriminate among wools of different quality, and there is marked overlapping of the grades. The Indian wools are highly heterogeneous and maximum variability is among fibers themselves. And grading does not impart any special feature which could improve the performance of graded lots over ungraded lots. So these are the observations of the CSWRI about the existing grading system. So now we are at the end of today's lecture. So let me summarize. So today we have discussed about the grading or classification of wool, what is grading, what is classification, what is the requirement, what are the main criteria for classification, what is the system used in American oldest system, then British system we have discussed. And then we have discussed about the preliminary classification of Indian wool in earlier days before the grading system. And then we have discussed different kind of grading system existing in India, that is the UNDP, then BIS system, and then style grading. And then there is a modified style grading by FAO. And finally, we have seen briefly about the mohair grading and some of the limitations of this grading system. So hope it will be easy for you to understand. You may further learn it from the lecture notes or from my book.